Holly here today with a new video for MarkerPop, and today we're going to be using products from My Favorite Things, and we're going to start out using the Merry Everything stamp set, along with the coordinating die set, and we're also going to be using the Starry Circle Die-namics, which is a cool little die that makes a fun starry background, and I'm also going to use the outer stitch rectangle frame from the Blueprints 29 Die-namics set. So I'm going to start out with a piece of Nina Solo White cardstock, cut at 5.5 by 4.25. I'm going to go ahead and cut the frame, and I'm also going to cut the inner circle piece at the same time while I'm cutting out the frame. So I'm showing it here upside down, but I did flip it before I die cut it, but just flip your pieces around and put them both where you want them to go since they're going to be inside of each other, and then just tape them down with some washi tape. And then I'm going to go ahead and run that through my Big Shot and cut that out, and I'll be right back. Once you have the pieces cut, you want to be really careful pulling your panel off of the cutting plates because we want to keep all those little stars that are on the inside for the part that I'm going to reuse the little stars. So just poke them out onto a container or an area of your desk and just make sure you keep track of where all those little stars are. And if you lose a couple along the way, it's not the end of the world because of the layout. We'll be able to cover up any spots where those stars aren't. And then after I have that all done, I'm going to go ahead and add some distressing to the center circle area. And I'm going to be using faded jeans and some chip sapphire. I'm just doing basic ink blending here with an ink blending tool. I'm adding the faded jeans first. And then I'm going to go back around the edges with the chip sapphire, just coming into the center a little bit, leaving the faded jeans mostly in the center. And then I blend it back over with the faded jean sponge. I don't add any more ink to it, just to kind of blend it out. And this makes the center of the circle a little bit lighter than the outer circle area. And then I'm going to go ahead and put the circle panel into my large Misty, and I'm going to go ahead and stamp the sentiment in the bottom corner there using some VersaFine black ink. Once I have the sentiment stamped in the corner there, I'm just going to go ahead and clean up my stamp and remove it from the Misty. And then I'm going to go ahead and stamp the two reindeer using my mini Misty, had them all lined up. I'm going to go ahead and stamp them using Tuxedo Black ink from Memento. And then I'm going to go ahead and color the images. I'm going to play some music, and I'll be back after I color, and I'll put the Copic color names up on the screen for you so you can follow along.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. Don't want a doll, no dinky tinker toy. I want a hippopotamus to play with and enjoy. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. I don't think Santa Claus will mind you. He won't have to use our dirty chimney flue. Just bring him through the front door, that's the easy thing to do. I can see room for him in our two-car garage. hippopotamus will do. No crocodiles or rhinoceroses. I only like hippopotamuses, and hippopotamuses like me too.
Once I have it all colored, I'm going to go ahead and die cut the two reindeer using the coordinating dies. I'm going to use my Big Shot, and then once I have them all cut out, I'm going to go ahead and add some foam tape to the back of the circle panel there. Instead of using regular Scotch foam tape, which is kind of thick, I'm just going to use some of that kitty foam tape, a piece that I have on my desk here. I'm just going to adhere the foam tape. I'm just going to cut it up in pieces so it fits, kind of like just making my own little puzzle there. It's always good to use up all your scraps. And I'm just using some tape runner that's just laying on my desk. I think it's a glue plus one. My ATG gun ran out, so just using that. And then I'm going to go ahead and cut down a piece of square of the Nina scrap that fits the opening behind the circle. I'm just going to glue that down. And then I'm going to go ahead and add some Tombow Mono liquid glue, just in little dots around the back of the star panel. And then I'm going to go ahead and put that into the center circle there. You still want to make sure you're careful when you're touching the distressing panel, especially a panel like this, because it's got a lot of ink on it, and if your fingerprints get on it, you're going to lift the ink up. So I just make sure I always use my tweezers when I'm touching that. Then you're going to want to go ahead and pick out all those little stars and put them down on your scrap paper. Once you have all the little stars out, I'm going to take a Spectrum Noir Sparkle Pen, I believe it is. This is a clear one. This pen and I have a love and hate relationship. Today I'm just using it right directly on those white pieces of paper. I'm not a super huge fan of this pen, but most people love it actually. But for me, it comes off all over the place, so I'm still trying to give it a shot. So if you have one, let me know what you think. I'm just not super happy with it. So anyway, I just pounce the sparkle pen all over the little stars, and then I'm going to go ahead and add a little teeny tiny dab of glue in the center of each star area. And then with my tweezers, I'm going to pick each star up and put them into the opening so that you see the stars sticking up. I mean, you could back this with some glitter paper, or you could use something to color each individual star in. This is just how I chose to do it today for the card. And then I'm going to go ahead and cut a piece of Nina Solar White's cardstock to 4 1/4 by 11, and I'm going to score it at 5 1/2 and fold it into an A2 size card base. And I'm just going to go ahead and score it there. And then I'm going to add some Tombow Mono glue to the back of my card panel, the front panel there with the image on it. And that just keeps the foam down. You could use the ATG gun too. That works really well with this kitty foam stuff. Fun foam stuff. Then I'm just going to line it up on the front of the card. And then I'm going to go ahead and add some Scotch foam to the back of the little reindeer images. This is the foam tape that comes on the big giant roll, or you can get the small rolls at your craft stores, or MarkerPop carries it in the store. So I'm going to cut it up and add that to the back of my reindeer. And then I'm going to just pop the tape off the back and position my reindeer on the front of the panel. And then when I'm all done, I'm going to go ahead and add some sparkle pen also to the scarves on the reindeer and the ornaments, I believe is where I added it. And that pretty much finishes up my card for today. So thanks for stopping by. I hope you guys are having a great Thanksgiving weekend if you live in the United States. And I will see you again next week. Take care. Bye-bye.